He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Now let us turn to God, our loving Father, as we offer our prayers and our petitions.
For prophets and teachers in the church, that their call be heard and put into action, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For government leaders and their efforts to end war throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick and the suffering, that healing may come through the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who preach the Word of God, that the Holy Spirit continue to visit them and inspire all that they say, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who gather at this table, that they work together for the greater glory of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for Natividad Fortuno, for whom this Mass is being offered, those names in our Book of Healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick, especially remember Father Joshi, Monsignor Al, and Brendan, that they all may feel God's tender love and compassion through their loved ones and caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for those who have died, especially Dennis Almedo, that the mark of Christ, that they may now be at peace with God in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for all of our special attentions, we now hold within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
O God, Almighty Father, graciously hear these prayers that we offer and the prayers that each of us have in our hearts for today. And we ask that you grant them according to your holy will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifices may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of our eternal salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Proclaim your glory as we join in their unending hymn of praise. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and time is so to our bishop with eternity, and with all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. We take a few moments as we call to mind the prayer for our own departed loved ones, that they may rest. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you.
communion hymn is number 466, In Every Age.
Thank you.
Well, good morning again. How are y'all doing? We have a blessing. Well, we have several blessings today. First of which is Father O'Brien for coming. For coming down today. He is such a beautiful spirit. I know him at St. Rose when he fills in up there too. It just brings a blessing to all that get to hear. A life blessing. You truly do. So thank you, Father. I'm here, Father. The other blessing today is it's Sweet Sunday, so we have coffee available and donuts out in the vestibule. It's a good place for us to come gather and to share the good news of the gospel that we heard today. And then last but not least, we have Vacation Bible Camp coming up real soon. And starting today, we have registration going on in the vestibule there. We have in the bulletin, there's a sign-up sheet that has more information about it. We do have a sliding scale this year for the tuition for that, but I just want to let you know that no one's going to get turned away. So whatever you can do, you want to make sure that your children are comforted. It's a beautiful experience. A lot of work, effort, and planning. Obviously, the planning it now goes into this. So it will be a beautiful experience for your children. And really would encourage you to sign them up and have them participate in this beautiful ministry. All right? Well, thank you. God bless you all.
God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live, that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth glorifying the Lord by your life.
And praise be to God.
The final hymn is number 384 with one voice.